In this video, I will talk about how to formulate the traveling salesman problem and its applications. An example of the typical traveling salesman problem is described as follows. Joe owes business in 5 cities. At the end of each year, he must take a tour to visit each of these cities exactly once and come back to the city he starts. We want to find the best order of visiting so that the total distance traveled will be minimized. The traveling salesman problem is a combinatorial optimization problem, and it has a finite number of feasible solutions. Here is a distance matrix. For example, from city 1 to city 2, the distance is C12 is equal to 132 miles. From city 1 to city 3, the distance is C13 is equal to 217 miles, and so on. From city 1 to city 1, the distance is C11 is equal to 0. However, we don't want to make unnecessary travels from one city directly to itself, because we may get trapped in this city forever when we are trying to solve this problem. So we assign a large positive number, M, which represents a large penalty, to this element in the distance matrix. The distance matrix is also called the cost matrix sometimes, and the elements represent the relevant traveling cost from one city to another. A traveling salesman problem is symmetric if the distance or cost from I to J is equal to the distance or cost from J to I. Otherwise, the problem is asymmetric. This situation may happen if from city I to city J is just a one-way road, and the return trip has to take a different route. We can formulate the traveling salesman problem as an integer programming problem. Let's define the decision variables. Xij is equal to 1 if Joe travels from city I to city J. Xij is equal to 0 otherwise. For I is not equal to J, I and J are from 1 to N. N is the number of the cities. We also need to define an auxiliary variable UI for each city I. This is a minimization problem. The objective function is the total distance traveled. So it is the sum of the distance from each section of the tour. The first constraint ensures that we must arrive at a city just once. The second constraint ensures that we must leave a city just once. The last constraint ensures that there is no subtour. An example of a subtour in a 5-city traveling salesman problem is that we start from city 1, we go to city 2 and city 3, then we come back to city 1 without covering cities 4 or 5 at all. For a traveling salesman problem with n cities, the number of decision variables, xij, is n times n. This equation will generate n equality constraints. So is this equation. This one will generate n minus 1 times n minus 1 inequality constraints, because we need to enumerate I and j from 2 to n. Therefore, this formulation is very difficult to solve using the branch and bound method, because it involves a large number of decision variables and constraints when n is large. I'll introduce two more efficient methods to solve it in later videos. One direct application of the traveling salesman problem is to plan a trip to different cities. There are some online tools that can help you do this. One such tool can be found at this website, http://gabweb.net/optimap. You can choose different cities and find the tour with the shortest traveling distance. For example, I'm trying to find the best tour for 7 cities: New York City, Pittsburgh, Chicago, Washington DC, Boston, Atlanta, and Detroit. The current order is obviously not optimal because it involves traveling back and forth from east to west and from north to south. Using this online tool, I find that the best solution is this: New York City, Boston, Pittsburgh, Detroit, Chicago, Atlanta, Washington, D.C., and back to New York City. The duration is 1 day, 21 hours, and 17 minutes. The total length is 2,946.8 miles. Of course, I can also go in the reverse direction because this is approximately a symmetric traveling salesman problem. Another application of the traveling salesman problem actually has nothing to do with salesmen. Printed circuit boards have many small holes through which chips and other components can be wired. These holes are required to be made as rapidly as possible by a moving drill. Finding the most efficient drilling sequence is a traveling salesman problem. Okay, that is how to formulate the traveling salesman problem and some applications. Thanks for watching.